Okay, this is James P. Madonna speaking from Megalife 21, the hardest hitting internet talk radio station on the planet, as seen on the web. And I would like to show you my new Talancia air plant from plantintheair.com. Plantintheair.com. As seen on Twitter and Facebook, just look it up, plantintheair.com. This is the one I got from them. Beautiful specimen. Okay. I think it's Junxia. I mean, I'm not good with the botanical names, but when I post this video on their Facebook page, they'll know what it is. Beautiful specimen. I got it online, and here I use floral wire, green floral wire that I get at the dollar store. In this case, a chain of dollar stores on the East Coast called the Dollar Tree. Can't be beat, only a buck. I make a little hook on one end, I wrap it around the air plant, the Talancia, and hook it right onto the cord, the blind cord. And then here I have a caput of Medusa, head of Medusa, attached the same way with the floral wire, green floral wire. And then down the line, this is, I think it's Palacia or something, I don't know. I tend to pick out the most unusual, far out, alien looking air plants. This one I think is, well, this one is a tricolor melon crater, but a young one, small one. I haven't done anything with that, with the wire. This one I believe is Streptophilus or something. See, all unusual Talancias. Alright, this one, of course, this is Ionantha Fuego, a small specimen. Okay, not a big one. Ionantha Fuego is supposed to get bright red. Okay, I have that in the seashell. These are from the Marathon Key, Florida. My sister and brother-in-law brought them back. They're typical, I'm not sure what species they are, but they are the typical air plants that you see in gift shops when you go on vacation in the tropics or Florida. I'm trying to identify it, but they're the typical ones. And I soak them once per week in dechlorinated water for 1 hour only. That's it. And then I drain them upside down so they don't rot. You cannot allow water to be trapped in between the leaves. You must drain them like I'm doing right now. Okay, I know it looks like an octopus, that head of Medusa, but yeah, you can't allow water to be trapped inside. And they need good ventilation, and they must dry out completely between waterings. Now, some people mist the Talancias 3 times a week. I never had luck with that. The soaking method works, but what I do is I don't just soak it in a bucket of water with synthetic fertilizer. I soak them in my aquarium where I have a large goldfish, and the goldfish are relatively dirty fish, and the water in the aquarium is rich in natural fertilizers, like, you know, almost like using manure, you know. So I've been using this system for years, using my aquarium water for all of my plants, even my herb garden outside. I've done it with veggies, I've done it with pepper plants, I've done it with tomato plants, whatever, and I've had great results. I read an article online about that, and I've been doing it ever since. So anyway, thank you. And I just wanted to share with you my unique air plant setup.